reform the system. The question is how. Now, there are those on the left who believe that the only way to fix the system is through a single-payer system like Canada's, where we would severely restrict the private insurance market and have the government provide coverage for everybody. On the right, there are those who argue that we should end employer-based systems and leave individuals to buy health insurance on their own. I have to say that there are arguments to be made for both these approaches. But either one would represent a radical shift that would disrupt the health care most people currently have. Since health care represents one-sixth of our economy, I believe it makes more sense to build on what works and fix what doesn't, rather than try to build an entirely new system from scratch.
Word up. We're watching the man, Barack Obama, talking about health care. He's doing some sort of State of the Union address to Congress. And simultaneously, we are listening to the replay of earlier today, Cash Flow, featuring Bob Dobbs and James Martinez. And they're talking about the union. That's been stated. No. State of the Union. Union of the State.
James Martinez. Okay. Bob, I listened to what you said about the. I want to go back to the part where you were describing that email that I forwarded to you. So you're saying that those people have to. We cannot judge those people with the typical moral standards that we would normally, unless we judge them through the bodies that you're referring to, correct?
Yes, I would condemn the congressional members and Obama, even before his statement tonight, that they do not use the four-body model. That is only a fair way to educate people of where they live. And it just has to be stated a few times, and people, obviously, it's like describing the new conditions in the weather, it's obvious on the perceptual level that that is our situation. It's not rocket science to understand the four-body model.
Right. And so, if we're going to judge those people for doing those things, then what that means that the people that are in courts, that are judges in courts on the Supreme Court, they have to work through those bodies as well, then.
Yes. And so where you have the cancellation of everything that civilized people know through literacy, all the institutions, those jobs, because we cannot seem to adapt to the new present situation where everything's disappeared and reappears every quantum fluctuation and then disappears, we rely on the literate institutions. So anybody who has a job or a role propping up the courts or Congress or Parliament, they're janitors, but they should be blessed because they're keeping the environments that we pray are still there. And it's only to the degree that we can realize they're not there that we can let them off. But the pressure of being a janitor under these conditions is horrible, and that's why they become drunk drivers and all that. But it's not their fault. It's because we don't want to do the work, so we force them to do the work.
So you're saying the entire moral fabric of the human race right now is in this position?
Yes, and it's not a problem when you understand how it got here.
Right.
But most people are going to find a problem in it because they're in time lag. They cannot understand their mind, which creates the rules you need to develop your relationship to other factors. The rulemaking factor of the mind does not know how to keep that going.
From Democrats and Republicans, and yes, from some of my opponents in both the primary and general election.
Purple Party!
Here are the details that every American needs to know about this plan. First, if you are among the hundreds of millions of Americans who already have health insurance through your job, or Medicare, or Medicaid, or the VA, nothing in this plan will require you or your employer to change the coverage of the doctor you have. Let me repeat this. Nothing in our plan requires you to change what you have.
You know, therapy groups and so forth.
People will make work for those people who want to be healers, who want to be therapists, and want to have a job and a role, like Hillary. She hopes that people are classified as ill so that she can have a role with them.
Right. But then, but with all that, that means the entire population of the world who's texting and computering and typing and faxing and instant messengering and everything else on the planet all at the same time while talking, while trying to have a conversation with somebody at the same time, they're all fit into this model of being addicted through this wireless world that we're in and going toward even more so.
Yeah, that's why to call addiction is erroneous. It's a flaw, a false premise, because
right.
you don't call your breathing an addiction to oxygen. One
right.
could say that if you want to move into the mystery landscape, but in general, for the average consumption of the union of the stated, is that oxygen breathing is not addiction, and that's what the chip body is. It's oxygen. It's part of, it's a new arm, a new leg. And this comes into this, you mentioned the top show, we're going to deal with some emails. We're getting some interesting emails from someone calls themselves Without Prejudice, which is ironic because the headline of the email is, money in electronic form is an inherent evil and is the death knell of our chemical existence or our chemical body. Without Prejudice writes, the Android meme is where the power center, the money paradigm, is now located. Now, if you've been listening closely to my show the last 8 months, the Android meme is gone. It's obsolete. There's only after images. So that is not true.
Diseases like breast cancer and colon cancer before they get worse. That makes sense. It saves money and it saves lives.
All right, this is Barack Obama's State of the Union. We're listening to also the replay of Bob Dobbs cash flow union of the stated. I'm trying to figure out what's going on, thinking about things. And this is the big day. This is the big day for Daniel Libby, Bob McBain, the HDL, because this is the 999, the day, September 9th, 2009, where it has been dropped. The conspiracy videos, the conspiracy music videos, including the Demon Slayer music video, which we're just going to check out a minute of here, just to give you a taste of it. I'll put the link in the info box once we post this. You can check it out. It goes a little something like this. And this is what it looks like, the DVD, Angelic Space Alien, featuring Conspiracy, the rapper, local Toronto rapper, and then this is Supporting Local Scene Action. That's the company that I'm on to, and, you know, just going to show you a bit of it. You can hear this on your own though, because I'll post the link. I'll make sure I post the link. We still got Obama going on here, State of the Union going on. We're gonna hear a bit more of this.